doctor and helpful by 6 feet. Additionally, it is advised to wear a face mask that covers both the nose and mouth in public settings or when you are unable to socially distance. Please remember these guidelines to keep yourself and others safe in our centrally owned and operated parks. Thank you for your understanding and cooperation. The vessel that you see arriving is the Casey J. Calloway. The Casey J. Calloway was built in 1952 by the Great Lakes Engineering Works at River Road, Michigan. She measures 767 feet in length, 70 feet in width, and 36 feet in depth. She is powered by a 7,700 horsepower steam turbine engine, which gives her a top speed of 14 knots, or about 16 miles per hour. She's also equipped with bow and stern thrusters to aid her maneuverability and course. The Calloway has 23 hatches on her deck, with open into 7 cargo holds located below deck. Each has covering measured 46 by 11 feet, and she has a maximum carry capacity of 25,300 tons. Above her deck, the thing that kind of looks like a crane is a 250-foot self-unloading boom, which allows her to unload her own cargo at a rate of 6,700 tons per hour without the aid of shoreside equipment. The Casey J. Calloway is currently owned by the Canadian National Railway of Montreal, Quebec, and she's operated by Great Lakes Fleet Incorporated and Sea Lakes Incorporated of Duluth, Minnesota. The Calloway is named for one of the board of directors of U.S. Steel, who served from 1944 until his death in 1961. He worked in the textile industry for many years and was the founder of Calloway Gardens in Georgia. She was one of three AAA class ships built for the Pittsburgh Steamship Division of U.S. Steel. The other two vessels, the Philip R. Clark and Arthur M. Anderson, still serve with the Calloway to this day. She sailed on the maiden voyage to Duluth in September of 1952. And she was lengthened by 120 feet in length. The Calloway was lengthened by 120 feet in 1974. And converted to a self-unloader in 1982 at Fraser Shipyard here in Superior. The Casey J. Calloway is arriving today with limestone. They will be discharging that limestone at the Red Stop in West Duluth. Then they will be shifting it to the Canadian. announcement for everybody. Our building is currently closed, so if you need to use the restroom at all, approximately a quarter block towards downtown, there are some porta potties on just the other side of Grandma's parking lot along Morse Street. Otherwise, the DeWitt Sites building, which is about a full block down next to the Little Andy's Cantina, has public restrooms in their building. So once again, there are porta potties on Morse Street on the other side of Grandma's parking lot, or there are public restrooms in the DeWitt Sites building at the intersection of Buchanan and Lake Avenue.